Hello, friends. Yours truly. I swear, nothing controversial today. I do want to share that my crew in Dreama, Nick, the leader of the band, is back from Africa as of last night. So I imagine that my video making will slow down a little bit. Actually, I kind of hope so. Not that I'll stop making videos, but that I'm looking forward to getting back to work on music with Nick. And getting involved with the next phase of post-production on his movie and seeing what happened. So, with that in mind, a couple things, and I'll show some more records. Glad you like the Zeppelin, Rob. Yeah, I put that cover on there. It came with no cover, so I made the cover for you. And definitely, that's something I thought you would appreciate. I've had it for a long time, actually. Let's talk about some records. I've just been going through. I didn't buy anything today, and I didn't get anything in the mail. I'm expecting some things, though, so I'm still hoping for things. But what I've been doing this week is I'll go and look for things that it's time to show that, and then it'll be kind of like, oh, well, let's show this, because the letter. So I was in the eyes, and a couple of punk records caught my eye, so I'm going to show a couple of the surviving punk rock records I have on. Punk rock records I still own. The first one is by an Italian punk rock band, Indigesti. Osservati dall'inganno. And this is amazing. This is like a shot of adrenaline right into the side of your head. This explodes with energy. Look at the picture. Look at this. You punkers know what this is about, that energy. I got a little story. You know, I got a lot of stories. Somehow, Indigesti ended up coming to Omaha on tour. And I knew about them before they came, so I went to the show. Like many shows I've been to over the years, I was the only black person for miles. I love the show. Moshed, you know. And then afterwards, as is my habit, I wanted to meet the band. They spoke no English. And when they saw me talking to someone trying to get to them, you could see the panic and fear on their faces. They were scared to death, you know. I can only imagine what they're thinking, you know. What is this black person going to do? You know what the word is I'm not going to use that they're probably thinking, you know. But I finally got to one of the promoters who spoke some broken Italian and explained to them who I was. Yeah, who I am here in Omaha, you know, when it comes to punk rock, and how much I just want to meet them. And so a couple of them hesitantly did agree to meet me, but they were scared to death of me. I'll never forget that. People, you know what I'm saying? It's really where a lot of my comments come from, is just, you know, the nature of man and the nature of human behavior is just, you know, makes me shake my head sometimes, you know. Another punk rock record that I kept, a not well-known band, but this kicks ass, is Inferno from Germany. Hibakusha, which I believe is a Japanese word. Frankly, folks, I don't know how I got turned on this. I didn't see these guys. But when I was hanging out on the scene, I was just absorbing all that I could. And just like with everything else, I want to know who the majors are, but I also want to know who the other people are. And so while everyone's talking about Black Flag and Minor Threat and Social Distortion, I'm steady looking at who else? Okay, those guys are good, but you're missing something. I know you're missing something. And I always find good stuff. Inferno is one of them. This is... that's excellent. Just, I don't know the language. Are the lyrics translated? Yeah. Are they translated? Yeah, they are. They are translated. But just like you saw in, if you watched my video last night where I shared with you how the Radiohead remix was soothing my soul, I don't need to know what the words say. I feel it. in the music and the way they spit it out. These next two records aren't punk, but they're aggressive, and they were close to the eyes, and I was looking in the sea, so I grabbed these. I absolutely love the Dillinger Escape Plan. Math rock, whatever you want to call it. I don't know what to call it. These guys play fast and furious and crazed and very, very good. I had the great fortune of seeing these guys live a few years ago and hanging out with them afterwards. And this show just blew my doors off. Just sparks flying. Music of the highest caliber. Just coming at you, beating you up. They beat you up with the music, and I loved every minute of it. If you look at my post, some of the music people I've met, you'll see a picture of me with Ben, the main guitarist. Here's another one of their albums, Miss Machine. Love this album. Love this album. If you're not familiar with these guys and you are interested in extreme music, really good musicianship, you like that intense energy, screaming, raging energy, can't go wrong with Dillinger Escape Plan. I love these guys. They have some newer records that I have, Ironworks, but not vinyl, and I believe they have something newer. I need to catch up with that. Okay, that came to my attention because I was looking in the seas to show Clear Light. Clear Light Orchestra, French band, similar to Gong in many ways, actually. I would say there is a similarity to Tim Blake's bubbling synthesizer work with Gong. Cyril Verdeaux is the man behind this band. And I think there is, yes, okay, I knew there was a Gong connection. Didier Malherbe, Bloom Dido Bad de Grasse, the sax and flute player, original Gong member, is on here. Another name that I recognize is Didier Lockwood, violinist, jazz violinist. I think he's done some work with Magma, but in his own right is an excellent musician. So I wanted to show this. Clear Light, this is one I have, Visions. And I can't comment a whole lot about the music except what I said, you know, it's bubbly. I'm showing records to the point now where I'm just showing records that some of these I haven't listened to for years, but it's like, I can't wait to show them to you until I listen to them because I don't have the, you know, I'll never show them. So some of these that I would like to talk more about, I can't because I have to go back and refamiliarize myself with them. I don't know how many Clear Light albums there are. There's more than what I have, but these are the two that I have. And this one is called Forever Blowing Bubbles. Yeah, there's another one with some kind of face on the cover, isn't there? Not the one there, but another. I can see it in my head. This is on Virgin. And let me see who's on here. Okay, so he's got David Cross, who is in King Crimson, on violin. Christian Boulle on guitar, who, I don't know who he was with before Steve Hillage, but he toured with Steve Hillage. Gilbert Artman of Lard Free is on here. Just amazing people. He works with the best. And again, just Joel Dugrenaut is on here. That's a name probably y'all don't recognize, but Joel Dugrenaut. Was he with Magma? I'm not sure. I just have one of his solo albums that I love. Love Joel Dugrenaut's bass playing. This is the period. This is the logo. This time period of Virgin. Virgin generally has had pretty interesting labels over the years. So I wanted to show those. Now here's another Clear Light, but it's completely unrelated. This is the U.S. psych pop Clear Light band from the 60s on Elektra. And this has a song I really like on it called Sand. And I understand that one of these guys became an actor. These are the people. I know that Dallas Taylor went on to play with Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. Ralph Schuckett has played with Todd Rundgren. Douglas Luban was in the original version of the band Dreams. Is it Cliff DeYoung? Is he an actor? I'm not real, even though I work in film, I'm not a film buff. I don't know a lot about film. And I'm thinking this is probably Yeah, that's got to be an original with the logo, with the band's logo on the label. That's probably an original pressing. This is very good. This is very good. Besides Sand, that's Mr. Blue is the other standout track for me. Mr. Blue. Clear Light. 60 Psych. Really highly recommend this. Love this album. Another album I've just been meaning to show and keep forgetting because it takes me forever to get over to the W's. But I know I've had this album probably 40 years, so I'm pretty sure this is an original copy, or at least a second pressing, of Robert Wyatt's first solo album, The End of an Era. Now, over the years, I've read about this album being panned as not very good. I have to beg to differ. This is similar to a Banana Moon in that it's kind of jam-based, but this one works a lot better. They're obviously not as stoned. There's a recurring theme. This is much more jazz-like. And if you like Robert Wyatt and Soft Machine, you will want to hear this. And I want to show the record because, like I say, I'm pretty sure this is a pretty old copy. I mean, I've had it for... Does 40 sound correct? I mean, I've been saying 30 years, but it's like I'm 56 years old, and it's like, you know, some of these records do go back to my teens and shortly after that, so 30 plus years old, this has been in my collection. Wanted to show this. This is one I say seek out. I don't know anything about this band. Took a chance on this, and I love this. I understand she has an album. I've never seen it. I'd like to find it. Marie and the Wildwood Flowers. This is UK. I gotta look at the date to tell you. We're looking at 1986. This is not goth, but it's atmospheric. That's the first word that comes to mind to try to describe how it's kind of darkly atmospheric. Salty Hound is kind of a haunting song. I think this is so good. And it's another one of those records where I find that it's so good. It's like, how did this get missed? How did this get missed? I'll go ahead and make a statement. I think, for example, DB Dude, you love PJ Harvey? She doesn't sound like PJ Harvey, but I bet you'd like this, Marie and the Wildwood Flowers. Soviet France, from England. A drone ambient collective. They've had a lot of different people come through here. Folks that have gone on to do other things, start the band Rapoon and others. I'm definitely leaving these out because I haven't played these forever. I love this music, and when I was into it, this stuff would just be like on repeat, especially in my days of stone. This would be on repeat. Turn this over, put it back on, get back into it, trip out, or whatever I'm doing, drawing, whatever. This one is called Les Musiciens de Soviet France, Misfits, Looney Tunes, and Squalid Criminals is the name of this. And their albums would come in fairly unique, interesting sleeves, like this one, the paper sleeve on the outside, and then the covering of the record itself, which is like just this big fold out, and then that folds out again into further artwork and information. I think the label that these are on is Red Rhino. Screaming Red Rhino Records, yeah. Yeah, these are kind of hard to come by now. I think you can find some of this stuff on CD now. But that's part of the joy of showing these records is I'm glad that I bought this stuff when I bought it. Knew it was something special. I'm really, really happy to be able to share it with you folks. Really happy. I'll take a quick break before I show the next Soviet France records and say I get these requests to give advice on turntables and equipment, and I'm just not the person. So if you happen to be watching fellow that requested recommendations on the equipment, I'm not the one, you know. Maybe you're fooled by my tape recorder. That was given to me, you know. It doesn't work anymore. I'd probably have to invest in it to get it working again. I mean, I can operate it by hand and do some, you know, use it experimentally like that, but the motor is just about shut. So he asked, do I buy online? Craig Moore, M-O-E-R-E-R, vinyl by mail. I'll go ahead and give you one of my sources from online. But I buy everywhere. You know, like most of you guys, I'm a hound. I can't help myself. You know, when I got a minute, I'm at the store. I'm at the record store. I'm, you know, now I'm at the Goodwill, you know. When I travel, that's what I want to do. Where are the record stores? So that's how I find them. I would suggest to you, my friend, to Google, not Google, but search here on YouTube for audio files, audio equipment. There are some brainiacs on here who can definitely tell you how to find what you're looking for. Okay, let's get back to Zoviet France. Here is another one of their albums that is in a very unique cover of aluminum foil with spray-painted dots for the graphic. This is the cover of the album, this foil. We're still talking about Zoviet with a Z or a S, but mainly they went by Zoviet France out of England. Let's see here. Here's the insert. Their stuff is so artful. You know, everything has art, and I love stuff like that. Quite enjoyed that about one of the most recent videos by Cool Ranch Dressing. Shelly and River, I think, are their names. He showed some cool records, beautiful artwork. Here's the other side. Let's see, I have to look at the record again too. This is again on Red Rhino. See, I need to put on my clunky glasses to tell you the name of this. Oh, this is Norsch. Norsch. I have this on CD too. This is really strong. Yeah, I got this on CD as well, so I could really, if I played the hell out of this. Norsch. Zoviet France, for you lovers of drone, ambient, noise, experimentation, music to expand those inner horizons, Zoviet France. Here's another one that comes in the outer paper bag. This one's entitled A Flock of Rotations. This is so cool. Thankfully, I have an extra day off like most of you folks. I hope all of you have an extra day off for Labor Day. Among other things, getting caught up with friends, Nick, and other folks. I hope to do some serious listening. Listening is healing. Listening is therapy. Listening is life. Music is life for me. It's more than entertainment. It's therapy. It's like, inject me, keep me going. Flock of Rotations, this is the artwork that comes on the inside of it. Cannot recommend this stuff enough for you adventurous-minded people or just you like good sound. You cannot go wrong with this. A Flock of Rotations, this is made in 1987. And it says it right here, this is the first edition. Of course it has to be, you know. Probably the first and only edition of this with this artwork in this form. I'm just going to lay this over here and put it together. The last Soviet Fruit Union album I have is the only one in a fairly standard cover. This one may have been seen by some of you. Maybe some of you have seen the other ones. But this one, I can almost tell you the names. Shouting at the Ground? Yeah, Shouting at the Ground. I remembered it. And this is a double album, double LP. Once again, the intriguing graphics. They very much fit the aesthetic of the sound. I'm not even going to use the word music. This is sound. Sound that heals. I'll go that far and say life is. I find myself thinking about the vinyl community a lot, and in a good way.